The Philippine Interior Secretary alleges a high-level police cover-up in the drug trafficking case of dismissed Police Master Sergeant Rodolfo Mayor Jr. This as he expressed disappointment over the slow progress of the investigation. Mayo was formerly the police drug enforcement group. He was arrested in October last year during a drug buy bust in Manila, which yielded 6.7 billion pesos worth of shampoo. He was dismissed just last month. Now, Interior Secretary Benner Abalos has directed 10 senior police officers allegedly involved in the cover-up to file their leave this week or face suspension. Mayo's arrest had previously prompted Abalos in January to call on all police colonels and generals to submit their courtesy resignations as a special panel looks into their possible links to illegal drugs.
Mag-leave na lang muna sila pending investigation. If not, they will be suspended pending investigation. Hindi kami papayag na masira ang ating bansa nitong droga. Kung kailangan linisin ang ranggo, gagawin namin ang sinumpaan namin dito.
Philippine prosecutors bear two aborted attempts to kill Negros Oriental Governor Noel De Gamo before he was assassinated on March 4th. The details are contained in an April 4th resolution shown by sources to ABS-CBN News. It describes how the persons accused in De Gamo's murder plan to either kill him in December with a rocket-propelled grenade or through a sniper shot in February. The April 4th resolution had indicted one of the supposed co-masterminds of the murder, Marvin Miranda. He was a longtime aide of embattled Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr. Now, another suspect alleged that Miranda had told Teves Jr. of the failed attempts to kill De Gamo. Teves' lawyer, Ferdinand De Pasha, says they will comment once they secure a copy of that resolution. As the suspended lawmaker has been invited to a Senate probe next Monday on the De Gamo killing. The senator leading the probe, Ronald De La Rosa, assures Teves will be given a fair hearing.
The mere fact na inibitahan natin sila, gusto natin marinig yung side nila. Gabi naman yung Kangaroo Court, gabi naman, hindi naman tayo mga NPA. Hindi naman tayo NPA nagagamit ng Kangaroo Court. I-handle natin itong hearing na hindi lalabas sa Kangaroo Court.
A Philippine Senate bill that seeks to revive the Mandatory Reserve Officers Training Corps, ROTC, ought to be passed into law before the year ends. Under the proposed measure, women and even foreign students will be required to undergo the ROTC program. Sharian Torres reports.
Bahagi po ng pagiging isang magulang ang ituro sa kanyang mga anak kung paano ipagtanggol ang sarili mula sa anumang mga banta na maaari niyang kaharapin.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa was able to sponsor the proposed return of the Reserve Officers Training Corps or ROTC program before both houses of Congress marked its Holy Week break. The ROTC Act contained in Committee Report 62, signed by 15 senators, mandates all college and vocational students, male and female, and even foreigners to take the program or they cannot graduate.
No exemption. Kagaya ng mga foreigners, you cannot subject them to yung to love our country, to die for our country because they belong to another country. And yet, hindi pa sila accepted sa ROTC, they will undergo a ROTC program with different program of instruction.
The program will provide physical military training as well as education about disaster response, environmental protection, intellectual and personality development, patriotism, and nationalism. The Department of National Defense, meanwhile, will allot 5 billion pesos for the free military uniform and combat boots of all ROTC trainees. De La Rosa rules out possible abuses in this program with the creation of a grievance committee in all schools to be monitored by the National Grievance and Monitoring Council.
Ako personally, mag-monitor talaga ako niyan dahil gagawin naman nila yan. Baka mamaya darating ang araw na sabihin na yung anak ko namatay sa hising sa ROTC dahil sa bato ROTC law. Oh, so hindi ko matanggap-tanggap yan ganyan na ganun ako ano, mahirap konsensya. Konsensya mo rin yan, no? Kaya siguruhin natin na maganda ang pagka-implementan nito.
Still, Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III could not understand the wisdom behind the inclusion of foreigners in the ROTC mandatory program. Much more, training foreigners using Filipino taxpayers' money. Students' reactions are mixed.
Okay naman po siya in a way na parang natutulungan po tayong maging aware sa nangyayari sa paligid, maging socially aware. Pero syempre, meron din po siyang disadvantages, lalo na if biglaan po siyang i-implement.
Sa akin, maganda siya kasi magkakaroon tayo ng karagdagang kaalaman at saka matututo tayong ano, depensa ng mga sarili natin. Pero andun yung takot ng mga kababaihan, kalalakihan, kasi during training may part na baka maabuso tayo habang nagtitraining.
Pero po siguro, hindi po ngayon siguro yung right time para po ipatupad ito kasi mas marami pa po tayong need na i-prioritize, lalo po sa education system natin ngayon, lalo nga po na nag-pandemic. Yung mga pang-aabuso po, hindi po siya malabong mangyari.
De La Rosa targets to have the ROTC bill passed into law within the year. Next to his sponsorship speech in the Senate will be the debate and period of amendments. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Top officials of the Philippines and the U.S. will hold talks in Washington Tuesday after the expansion of their defense cooperation agreement. The meeting will be led by U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken and Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin. The Philippine delegation will be represented by Foreign Affairs Chief Enrique Manalo and Defense Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. The meeting comes amid China's opposition to Manila and Washington's expanded enhanced defense cooperation agreement. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has said the EDCA sites won't be used for any offensive actions.
Hindi naman siguro kataka-taka dahil nag-aalala sila, pero hindi tayo papayag na gamitin ang mga bases natin para sa kahit anong offensive na action. Kaya kung wala namang sumusugod sa atin, hindi na sila kailangan mag-alala dahil hindi naman sila natin lalabanan. So, existing na yan. Meron na tayong kampo diyan na dati pa. At ang kaibahan lamang at sa ginawa natin dito ay yung EDCA ay binibigyan natin ng pagkakataon ang ating mga our only treaty partner, which is the United States. We give them a chance to be able to come and help us in any way, lalong-lalo na nag-umpisa talaga yan sa pagtulong sa mga disaster relief.
The total number of EDCA sites now stands at 9, with the new locations identified in Cagayan, Isabela, and Palawan.
Manila and Washington will also launch their largest joint military drills Tuesday. Around 5,400 Filipino soldiers and more than 12,000 U.S. military personnel will train shoulder to shoulder. The drills will include live fire training, humanitarian assistance, and disaster relief preparedness. This year's Balikatan will be held until April 28 in various areas of the country, including Palawan, Antique, and parts of Northern Luzon.
U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken will visit Vietnam later this week as tensions flare in the region. According to the State Department, Blinken will discuss Washington's shared vision of a peaceful and resilient Indo-Pacific region with Vietnam. He will visit Hanoi on his way to the Group of Seven Foreign Ministers meeting this weekend in Japan. Vietnam has long-standing tensions with China, whose own ties with the U.S. have also deteriorated in recent years. On Monday, China completed military drills around Taiwan in the latest show of force against the South ruled island after its president traveled to the U.S.
Japan concerned over China's military drills around Taiwan. The Japanese ambassador to the Philippines says the exercises affect the peace and security of Japan and other countries in the region. He also calls for a resolution of issues surrounding Taiwan through dialogue and not by force.
Repeated large-scale military action in the vicinity by a neighbor seriously affect the peace and security of Japan and other countries in the region, as well as the safety and livelihood of the other citizens. Committed to our shared vision of a free and open Indo-Pacific, we firmly oppose unilateral attempt to change the status quo by force, especially in the East and South China Sea. We cannot allow any military and economic power to undermine the very foundation of existing global order and plunge the world into conflict and chaos and tragedy.